Chairman, yes, sir. I do have some concern. There's been some items or some letters, calls about the statute there at the courthouse and how we're going to kind of do that. But what I'd like to do is, if I could, I'd like to have our council entertain the process of what we should or should not do and how we may do that.
Okay.
Mr. Chairman?
Yes, sir, Mr. Meyer.
The General Assembly passed, historically and for many years, and including right this minute, a county does not have the ability to move around, take down, recontextualize war monuments in general. As of July 1, the county will have the ability to do so. However, it's not a general ability to do whatever it wants, as it can do with most property. Here at Greenfield, this is county property. If we want to move a wall around, we can move a wall around. That's part of what means to own property. With respect to war monuments, the General Assembly has limited our authority to take those same sorts of actions. In essence, what the new law provides is that we need to go through some type of listening period before we take any action in order to make sure that the public is given full opportunity to participate in the decision of what, if anything, to do with a war memorial. First thing that we would need to do, which is a requirement regardless of what we decide to do with it, is we would need to determine whether we actually own it or whether there were any strings on that donation. And given that my understanding is that that donation took place in the late 19th century, I don't know what that background would be, although I could undertake that research and spend the time to figure that out. After we've established that the county in fact owns it, has the ability to dispose of it in various different ways, what we would need to do is publish in a newspaper of general circulation in the locality our intent to hold a public hearing on what to do with it. That public hearing would have to be at least 30 days after the first publication of the public notice. And we would be able to receive both public comment in writing by email and at a physical public hearing here in Greenfield at a board meeting. If you wanted to, you could also request the circuit court to order an advisory referendum, which would mean that at an election, you could have a question on the referendum on the ballot that said, should the Board of Supervisors consider removal or relocation of the war memorial at whichever one happened to be? And it would be advisory. The Board of Supervisors could decide to do something different. However, obviously, the outcome of a referendum speaks very loudly, even if you don't have to follow it specifically. So that's the outcome there. I would say that given that this law is not yet in effect, I don't think we have power quite yet to do anything or necessarily to schedule anything. But if you chose to do so in, say, July or August to start considering or moving forward on this kind of a process to consider one of our war memorials, what to do with it. Another provision of this law is that it would have to be offered to museums, historical societies, other units of government, or military battlefields. So that would, for instance, give us the ability to offer it to one of the historical societies or potentially one of the historical groups that helps to maintain one of our cemeteries. Just, there's a long list of different people that you could offer it to in that situation, rather than it being completely removed or placed in mothballs. But right at the moment, there's not much that we can do. After July 1st, we can start a public conversation and consider different options under the provisions of this statute.
Thank you.
Thank you.